Hi, this is Derek Jones. Just want to show you how to use the folder tracks and VCAs in Studio One to help with something like a multi-out instrument, in this case a drum kit. And I have a multi-out instrument Impact XT here that is set up to use just a few of the items, a kick, snare, crash, and three toms down here. And I've separated those out in the track view up here into individual tracks, and you don't have to do that with the nice new drum editor in Studio One 4. You can put all of your items on one track, but sometimes it's nice to have them separated out so you can manipulate them individually. And so that's what I've done here. I've also created channels in the mixer which correspond to each of the individual tracks, and they're linked in the pane over here. You can see the linkage to the actual channel in the mixer as well. Okay. Now, I've also created two folders. I've got a top-level folder here, the drums folder, and I've also got the toms folder, and they're linked to the drum VCA and the tom VCA, which I created afterwards, and that's done using this menu here. And so there's the linkage to the VCAs. And that's rather nice because it means I can manipulate all the toms levels here, or I can individually manipulate the tom levels. Or because that's nested within the top-level drum folder and linked VCA, I can manipulate all the drum kit at once or individual items again in it, like so. So that's the first level of organization. I can also collapse these, which means that it's easier to work with if you have a lot of tracks, or you can collapse the whole kit as well, like so, and expand things out very nicely. So that's the first thing. The next thing is in terms of grouping. Now, I can make an individual change to this particular track. Let's say I want to cut it here, no problem. And I could then move that around, do something with it, not an issue. What's nice is that if you click on the folder track and do your editing, you actually make a change to all the items in there very easily, which is rather cool. And I didn't have to do grouping or ungrouping to do that. However, there is an advantage to using grouping. Let's do something else. Let's add another item to my bus here. So let's decide to put, say, what have I got? Let's do something like something strange, like a flanger on my high tom. All right, so let's put the flanger on my high tom. There it is. And that only added it to that tom. Cool. Let's take that off again. And now let's decide I want to put, say, a gate on all of these. Now, one way you could do it is you could group them all, temporarily group them all, like so, or you can create a group and then work with that group. Yeah, sure. But here's a neat little thing. Look, if I click on that and then just select all of them, it does that for me. Which means then, if I do something like let's add a gate this time, and let's put that on there, I've added a gate to all of those three all at once. And if I unclick that, then I can individually do things to that. Let's say remove, oh, I've got them all selected still, but let's individually just remove it off of that particular track, like so. Rather useful. Right, let's back up on that. And now, because these are nested, let's do the same thing to the whole drum kit all at once. Let's undo that. Let's click on this one, and we'll actually include that one when I do it. Let's click on this and select just one of the items. And now let me add a gate to everything on here all at once. Very easy to do. And now I've got gates across all of my kit. Of course, I probably want to put those at the front here, and I could alter that in a moment. But this is a very nice feature. And again, if I undo that and then just go back to my snare, I can do something individual to the snare. Let's add, say, an expander to my snare. And I've just added that now to the snare. So without having to go through here and do things with the grouping menu or anything like that, just by using this little fellow up here, I can group things together directly from here, which is very nice. So hope that's useful. Let's actually just hear what it sounds like, shall we? I've got gates on here, and let's leave them on, see what it goes like. Not bad. You know what, I think maybe let's have a bit more high tom. Let's take that up a bit. Now the high tom's a bit too high, so let's bring that down again and take that up. See how easy it is to manipulate that with the VCAs. It's very easy to manipulate that with the VCAs, and again, I can do the whole kit. Hope that's helpful and shows you how you can use this with a very nice grouping facility with using folders. Thanks for watching.